We just got back from a morning hike and I'm getting ready to make my dog's lunch. We do species specific or what's called biologically appropriate raw feeding. We've been doing that for about 10 years. And I'm probably considered more a rotation feeder. I do ground meat, ground bone feeding, as well as carcass feeding. We do use kibble on some of our busier days or when I'm traveling. And then I also let my dogs have home cooked. If I'm making a meal that's appropriate for them as well. I think home cooked is really good, especially if it's made with a lot of love. There's good energy in that, and I'm a true believer in that. But I kind of wanted to demystify what it actually looks like to make a home raw meal. There's a lot of controversy out there about it. I'm not sure quite why there's controversy about it. But we also have other raw feeding videos on our YouTube channel. If you just put raw feeding into the link, I believe two are carcass feeding and one is a multiple dog household, how to save
The
the
whole lunch
PC.
together, it's pretty simple. It's not rocket science. And that's something I think really important to remember because some people have been led to believe that it's very labor intensive and time consuming. And it can be if you don't have a plan, but really it's simple, simple, simple. And if you handle meat in your household for yourself, for you and your family, like for barbecues or roasts or anything like that at night, storing raw product for your dog is really no
Okay,
different at
so
all.
inside our fridge, my husband's job is to pull frozen raw meat, organ meats, meat with bone, anything we have out, and he puts it in this dish in the fridge, and so it's all contained. We also have this drawer, here, let me open this up. This drawer that's dedicated just to raw product. And so if you have raw meat, in your refrigerator, it's always good to separate it from the fruits and vegetables and just to keep it separate. It's just good food handling. It's common sense. And then here, and with all poultry, just like you would do for yourself, always make sure you rinse it first. We have turkey backs, and I have cut these into a little bit smaller pieces to feed. We've got some turkey organ meats, the turkey neck. We have more of the organ meats. We have some ground turkey. This was on sale, so we have some of that. We have some beef, and I've cut these big chunks of fat off the side of it. I don't really like feeding that kind of big chunky fat stuff to my dogs, but it's hard on my older dogs as well. And you can see it's just really nice. You can see nice color. Whatever meat you use, whether you find it on sale or it's your own meat or you get it from a local producer, just make sure it all has beautiful, healthy color because that's part of the raw feeding is you're starting with really
This
great
mixture of
product.
beef, heart, kidney, and liver. And that'll go in as far as my organ meats for our
Okay,
lunch.
and this is green tripe. We buy it in 5 pound logs and then we section it off into baggies. It has a reputation of being super stinky and it kind of is, but it's not unpleasant. I think there's worse smells in the world. But green tripe is the stomach lining from the cow, but it's before it's been rinsed and bleached, so it still has a lot of the plant product. It's awesome for a source for digestive enzymes. And if there's one thing you should add to your dog's food every day, it would be a little bit of
I put
green
the
tripe.
grinder together. This intimidates a lot of people and it shouldn't. This particular grinder, it's a Waring Pro, and I got it during hunting season at Costco, and I believe this one was $99, and they have a bigger, beefier one, but that's for like processing a whole elk, and that's not my purpose. So before you put everything together, you want to make sure that your grinder is unplugged. The first part of the assembly you want to put together here, this is the shaft where you're going to be feeding all of the meat right through here. This is one of the grinder blades inside, and this has a slot that fits in. So we want to put this in, and you want to rotate it until it locks in place. This is the outside blade that goes on, and this just fits right over. And the nice thing is everything has a really nice fit to it. There's really only one way for it to all fit together. And this particular meat grinder comes with four different levels of sizes you can grind to. This is one of the thicker ones, and I prefer this one. My husband likes the thinner one, the sausage making one. But I like to see the chunks of meat and chunks of bone, and I think my dogs enjoy that a little bit more, but that'll be a debate forever between my husband and I. And then you do just want to slip this on, and this one's the one that you want to make sure that fits in here nicely, and you can feel it seat itself right in here. And then you have the cap that holds this whole assembly together. And you want to screw that on till it holds in place. And then this locks this top assembly in place. Because as you're putting big chunks of meat in there, it kind of wobbles a little bit. So you just make sure everything's down tight. And then this is the feeder tray that goes on the top. And you just load your meat in here and slowly feed it. And I think this is hands down the most important part of the whole assembly. You never want to push your finger into a grinder, and every single meat grinder comes with huge warnings, don't put your fingers in. This is actually the plunger that you can use to push the meat down with, because you want to make sure it goes down it through the funnel into the grinder.
And so this is what it looks like all assembled. And here's the feeder tray on top. And the most important thing when you're putting your whole grinder together is that it's unplugged. You don't plug it in until you're ready to start working. This particular grinder has three settings. It has on, off, and reverse. And I think reverse rocks. And that's my most favorite setting, because if meat gets jammed in there instead of taking everything apart, you can just hit reverse and it backs it out.
The grinder is kind of loud, so I'll let you hear what it sounds like as we get going. And I'm just going to put a bowl here and then feed in. So this is what we have, what we're doing today. We have yams, blueberries, our mixture of meats and organ meats and bone. And we have some green tripe, and we're going to be feeding it in here and see what's coming out here. So let me turn it on and show you what it kind of looks like. For my four border collies, probably 2-2.5 days, about that. Yeah, so, and it takes all of about 10-15 minutes to do. And here's the beautiful mixture, and you want to make sure that all the meats, all the organ meats, are mixed in really well. And we'll get that, and then we have some hungry dogs. And we'll see how they like it. My guess is they're gonna love it. And there's Seeker. And that's usually the response we get. And then let's see Miss Franny. And Franny just gets a little bit less because she's a little bit older and her tummy's not dealing with big right now. This is her favorite time of the day. And this is what we like to see, is dogs that don't turn their head away when you set their food down. But you set their food down and they say, this is exactly what I need to nourish my body. And dogs are pretty good at letting you know that. So, and Franny will be 14 this year. So to see her have such a healthy appetite is thrilling. And here's Mr. Seeker. And after we're all done bagging and putting things away, our dogs get to lick the bowl. Just like you guys lick the cake batter bowl, our dogs get to lick the mixing bowl. They wait around for this at the very end. And everything I made, we just fed four border collies, and I put the rest in bags, and this will be good for about another meal and a half with all four of my dogs.
So it makes me feel good to know that I'm giving them something really healthy that gives them the nutrients that they need in order to take care of their health the way it should be taken care of. But that their food looks so alive. It's got a color, that says fresh and wholesome and nutritious.